didn't see that one.
I could see it with Noah.
Danielle wanted some video for grandparents.
And I sure would like some sweet company. And I'm leaving tomorrow. What do you say? When I'm gone.
Good morning, everybody, and welcome. I'm Allison Weaver, and I'm here to navigate us through this day. I too may have a couple of tears as we go through this, and tears are just fine. And I think to start us all, I would say, could we all just take a couple of really big breaths? Okay. Today we gather to pay tribute to a wonderful, energetic, a bit of a daredevil, a busy, a cuddler, a limit pusher, loved loud music, loved life boy named Noah. Today is a day we gather as family, friends, and community. This is what will help Colin, Danielle, Jackson, and Oakley, aunts, uncles, and grandparents, navigate through this time that all of us wish we wouldn't have to be here for. But we are here to be the strong blocks to help hold up this amazing family. We will reach out, we will hold them, and we will care. And we will have a time at the end of the tribute for Noah for other people to come up and share a story of Noah with us. And today, I'd really like to make a special mention of our honorary pallbearers. And if you boys are brave enough, I'm going to have you stand up, okay? So our first pallbearer is Jackson. And we have Oakley. And we have Riker. Where's Riker? There he is. And we have Brody. Boys, thank you. You have a very important role today because you are here to give support to our big pallbearers who are here to help carry Noah. Thank you, boys. You can be seated. So today we are going to share some stories and we're going to share a poem. And at this time, I would invite Corey Lynn to come forward to share this poem, a poem with us.
Morning. Oh, I promised I would try not to cry my eyes out for Danielle. The Hiloukins have become like family to us over the past few years, and we love their boys like our own. Noah will always hold a special place in our hearts, and I'll always remember his sheepish, oh man, when he was busted for peeing on the toilet seat and not cleaning it up. I wanted to read a poem, and like I said, I'm going to try not to bawl my eyes out for you, Danielle. It's called We Only Wanted You. They say memories are golden. Well, maybe that is true. We never wanted memories. We only wanted you. A million times we needed you. A million times we cried. If love alone could have saved you, you never would have died. In life, we love you dearly. In death, we love you still. In our hearts, you hold a place no one could ever fill. If tears could build a stairway and heartache make a lane, we'd walk the path to heaven and bring you back again. Love you guys.
Thank you, Corey Lynn. I think Noah would love your hair, too. At this time, we're going to invite Adam Thor to come up, and he's going to share Noah's story with us.
You know, I've made 300-some speeches in my life. Most of them have been in the dressing room or on the ice. I promise not to yell or throw any sticks. My name is Adam Thor, and I was Noah's coach last year in hockey. I was honored to be asked to speak to you today about a wonderful little boy that I had the privilege of getting to know over the past few years. Noah, although a child, was larger than life and far bigger than words. I'll do my best. Noah was born May 24, 2013 in Saskatoon to Colin and Danielle. He returned home to the acreage south of Kitscotty, where the family currently lives. Noah was a kind-hearted boy who was full of energy and excitement. Noah was a busy boy right from the start. He was always on the go and was up for anything. Noah enjoyed school, hockey, ball, swimming, and taekwondo. He had recently started taking his bike and scooter to the skate park in Lloyd and loved to ride around there. At home, he enjoyed the trampoline, music, and video games with his brothers Oakley and Jackson. Taekwondo, he was remembered for his feistiness and determination. He always did his best to follow what was taught. He was awarded an honorary black belt. Noah liked school and loved learning to read and math. He took pride in his accomplishments in school and was always looking to succeed. He made sure he read his 15 minutes a day and wanted to be sure he got his check marks on his Readopoly board. He loved his Robert Munch books the most and read them all many times over. After reaching out to some of the teachers who taught Noah over the past few years, I have a few words to share from them. Crystal Becker, who taught Noah pre-K, had this to say about him. Noah had one speed, and that was go. His smile was one that will be cherished and never forgotten. Those little chiclet front teeth and pudgy cheeks will live on forever in our hearts. The first day of pre-K, he was outside at the end of the day. He had to go to the bathroom. Instead of telling anyone, he just went to the edge of the playground and turned towards the trees. When we all looked over, all we saw was a bare little bum as he peed in the grass. Mrs. Garnier and the kindergarten staff wrote, Noah became quite the perfectionist in kindergarten. The fine details, especially in his coloring, were so important to him. He loved color. He was one of the first students of the craft table during Sanders. Noah always had the best intentions and was such a kind-hearted boy. When he put his mind to something, there was no stopping him. Mrs. McWilliam, Noah's grade one teacher, said, Noah was a detailed guy who always noticed the changes in the classroom on Monday morning. He loved books and always wanted to be front and center at story time. First in line was where he always wanted to be, so he was excited to move on to the next activity in his day. No one had more capitals and exclamation points in their stories as Noah. He was as intense in his stories as he was in real life. He was always determined to do his best and would take the time when something was hard to be successful. Mrs. Beek from grade two and some of her EAs had this to say about Noah. Noah was always a kind leader with a gigantic heart. I will always remember Noah running as fast as he could to be first in the Terry Fox run with the biggest smile on his face. He always wanted to be first in everything he did. I find it fitting that Noah's favorite color was gold, when he always loved to be the first in everything he did. Noah was a smart, independent, determined young man who always wanted to do his best and make you proud. Sparkle in his grin will never be forgotten. He always loved being outside and playing with his friends. He always stuck up for himself and for others if needed. We'll always remember him on the saucer swing, pumping for all his might, trying to get as high as possible. But if someone was on with him and got scared, he would slow down for them. He was very kind and caring. I always loved his questions. He always wanted to clarify words he didn't know and was genuinely interested in the answers and definitions. He was serious about all his schoolwork. Some quotes from Noah's classmates. He was a great hockey player that loved to score, but helped us all score too. He was a fast skater. Noah always told jokes and made funny faces on the bus to make us all laugh. I remember being nervous about starting kindergarten, and Noah said hi to me and asked me to play with him. I am thankful that he was in my class and he was my friend. Noah spent lots of time with his extended family over the years, from ski trips to Banff with Grandpa Lucan and his older cousins Trent and Tay, to making cookies with Nana Hill. Went on gator rides with Grandma and Grandpa Hill through the trees. He enjoyed kneeboarding with Grandma and Grandpa Lucan. Loved hanging out with all of his family members. On the annual ski trip to Banff, they'd stay in a condo and Noah was either skiing or in the pool. Colin told me he must have made 1,000 trips down the water slide. Noah's brothers were very important to him. He always made sure Oakley was included in everything, and the two of them spent a lot of time playing together. Noah liked to have sleepovers with Oakley in the bunk beds. All three boys would play Mario Kart and Minecraft together and enjoyed the time spent with each other. Noah looked up to Jackson and always wanted to do whatever he did. Even though he was younger and smaller, he wanted to do it the same as his big brother. Of course, they had their differences at times and loved to fight with each other, as all brothers do. But as always, they would get over it and be off to the next adventure together. Noah loved playing in the trampoline, jumping on the bales with both of his brothers. I was involved with Noah for the last few years in the sports that he played with my son. I helped coach Noah in ball and coached him in hockey as well. Noah and I did not always see eye to eye. Took me a while to figure out how he worked. I could make him do push-ups at hockey and it wouldn't faze him. But if I could make him laugh or smile, I knew I had him. Little did I know, he was teaching me as well. I'll always remember one of our final games last year. Our assistant, Jay, talked to Noah about sticking with Frog Lake's top player. And Noah stuck to him like glue. That poor kid couldn't move without Noah being right on him. Noah did exactly what was asked of him, shut down their top scorer. We're both so proud of how far Noah came last year in hockey. He grew not only as a player, but as a person. He was always excited to be at the rink and was always one of the loudest supporters of his teammates. We always knew Noah was ready to go. With his music blaring, his do-rag on under his helmet. There'll always be a spot on my team for Noah. I missed a few things about him and hockey. The first year Noah played hockey, he hit everything that moved. The opposition, his own teammates, the rink dividers, the net, the boards, you name it. He took it out. Noah cheered for Calgary just for spite, because all the rest of the family cheered for the Oilers. Noah always had a twinkle in his eye and a mischievous smile. You could read him like a book, because he never had a very good poker face. And Danielle told me a story of when she took Oakley to a speech assessment one time. Noah was playing and came out with something under his shirt. When Danielle asked him what was under his shirt, he told her, "Nothing, Mama." His face totally gave him away. When she asked again, he came out with a truck that he liked from under his shirt. He could always tell when trouble was brewing or had already been accomplished. He could never hide the look in his eyes or that wry little smile. One of the most memorable times at the Lucan household was bedtime. Danielle can remember singing Noah, "You Are My Sunshine," to get him to relax and go to bed. Sometimes he'd sing along and other times just listen. If that didn't work, Noah was off to see his dad for a cuddle and a chat. Colin would tell Noah to count some sheep or sing a song in his head to help him wind down and go to bed. Noah, as every boy does, adored his hero, his dad. There are surely countless memories we could share here today, as everyone I've talked to all have special memories of Noah. He was a special guy that touched everyone's lives in one way or another. I'd like to thank the community of Kitscotty for their unbelievable support of this family. Meals and phone calls, texts and messages, it's all greatly appreciated. Friends and family for all the love and compassion over this last while. It's great to see us all come together to help a family in their time of need. Friendship is a golden thread that ties the world together. Noah was our golden thread. He will be sorely missed, always loved, and never forgotten.
Thank you, Adam. Now I have a little story for the kids, and I was so glad that Adam mentioned the golden thread, because my story is about an invisible string. There were two little twins named Liza and Jeremy who were asleep one calm, quiet night. And suddenly, it began to rain so hard, thunder rumbled until it got so loud, it woke them up. "Mommy, Mommy," they cried out as they ran to her. "Don't worry, you two, it's just a storm making all that noise. Go back to bed." "We want to stay close to you," said Jeremy. "We're scared." Mom said, "You know, we're always together, no matter what. But how can we be together when you're out here and we're in bed?" I think this sounds a little bit like Noah. Mom held something right in front of them and said, "This is how." And she held up this pretend string, an invisible string. "This is how," she said. Rubbing their sleepy eyes, the twins came closer to see what Mom was holding. I was about your age when my mommy first told me about the invisible string. I don't see a string, said Jeremy. You don't see the invisible string? People who love each other are always connected by a very special string made of love. But if you can't see it, how do you know if it's there? Asked Liza. Even though you can't see it with your eyes, you can feel it with your heart and know that you are always connected to everyone you love. How far can the string reach? Anywhere and everywhere, said Mom. Would it reach me even if I was in a submarine, if I was a submarine captain deep in the ocean? Asked Jeremy. Yes, said Mom, even there. Or a mountain climber? Yes, even there. A ballerina in France? Even there. A jungle explorer? Even there. How about an astronaut in space? Yes, Mom said, even there. And then Jeremy quietly asked, would it reach all the way up to Uncle Brian, who is not here anymore? Yes, even there. Does the string go away when you're mad at us? Never, said Mom. Love is stronger than anger. As long as love is in your heart, the string will always be there. Even when you get older and can't agree about things, like what movie to see, what game to play in the back seat, or what time to go to bed. Oh, that's right. You too should be back in bed. And with all that, they laughed as Mom chased the twins back to their beds. Within a few minutes, they were asleep, even though the storm was still making those loud noises outside. And as they slept, they started dreaming of all the invisible strings they have, all the strings their friends have and their friends have, until everyone in the world was connected by an invisible string. So deep down inside, they know clearly no one is ever alone, and we always have that wonderful connection of the string of love. At this time, family and community is so important. And this Kitscotty community and this family and friends can be commended for their strength, for their being the pillars that need to help hold up the Hill Lucan family right now. And you know, it's always amazing in difficult times how you're so surprised how everybody comes together and they are there for you. And we know, as we all sit in these chairs, that this family would do the exact same thing for us if we were going through these very hard times. But when our base stays really strong, the top has lots of support. Because right now, the top is feeling a little wibbly wobbly because there's a piece now missing from this wonderful family. Our heart is like a puzzle, and the puzzle grows with more pieces as we build friendships, as we get older, as we're married, as we have children. And it becomes even a complicated jigsaw puzzle. Now, unfortunately, we have a piece that's missing from our puzzle. And as days move along, you will search for the piece to fill the spot in your heart. And that is when you reach for your memories of love you have for Noah. Cherish the memories, allow the tears to flow. There will be days of anger and frustration, and that's okay, boys. You're going to get angry sometimes, and you're going to be frustrated, and you just tell Mom and Dad, it's just one of those days. And Mom and Dad are going to have some of those days too. Sometimes when they just need to be a little bit by themselves and have that. But let them be by themselves for just a little while, and then you go grab onto their hands and you guys go do something together. Cherish those memories and hold on tight. There is the invisible string to hold on to. But here's the deal, everybody who's here today with the string. There's going to be days when you want to let go. But just keep holding on. And when you're too tired to hold on, there's this incredible group of support who will hold on for you. And some days the light is not going to feel very bright in the day, but there's people here who will bring you the light. As I look out in this room, you are loved and supported by so many people. For this mom and dad and the brothers and the grandparents and the aunts and the uncles and friends, be there for each other. Check in with each other. Check in tomorrow. Check in 2 weeks. Check in 6 months. Check in 1 year. Check in 5 years. Check in 10 years. Because that little piece of puzzle isn't going to come back, but with you there, you will help to bring the love that needs to hold the puzzle together that's missing its one piece. Now, for all the kids who are here, and maybe who are listening, death is a really hard thing to understand. And you might have lots of questions. And I'm so happy to see teachers that are here today, and friends and grandparents. And remember, if something is scaring you and you're not sure about it, always ask. And it's okay to have a cry, and it's okay to maybe get mad, and you gotta go kick the dirt a little bit to figure out what's going on. But do remember, when you go to school the next day and you're having one of those tough days, you can just tell your teacher, I'm having a really hard day today. It's just a tough day. And to friends out there, it's okay to have a tough day. And we'll all reach out and we'll be there to help and to help navigate through this time to keep that puzzle together. But here is just one little quote I want to give, and then we're going to ask if anyone has a story, and I know Crystal Becker has a story she would like to share. And grief never ends, but it changes. It's a passage, not a place to stay. Grief is not a sign of weakness or a lack of strength. It is the price of love. So at this time, I'm going to, if Crystal is wanting to, going to invite her up to share a story. And then if anybody else has a story to share, and then we'll be doing our final farewell to Noah.
What, you could be up here all day. I had that little boy for 1 year. He was 4. But he came to school with all the 5-year-olds, and he thought he was 5. He was going to do everything those 5-year-olds did. He was going to write his name, and he was going to do it by himself. And he did. We went through line by line, circle by circle. And he looked up at me, and he lit up like a Christmas tree. And I said, you did it. He said, I did it. And I said, and you can do it every time now. And he says, yes, I can, all by myself. He lit up like a Christmas tree over everything. And that's what I remember about him. I would see him at the hockey rink. You're going to come watch me play hockey? Yes, I am. He'd sit on the ice, he'd stop, and he'd wave, and he'd light up like a Christmas tree. And that's the memory I want of Noah to go on. I think of that now every time I look at one of these little people, I light up like a Christmas tree. Every one of them have a piece of my heart. Noah will always have a piece of my heart, and so when I see you and I light up like a Christmas tree, please remember him.
Now, is there anybody else who would like to share a story about Noah? What I loved when Danielle and Colin asked, you know, could we have a few stories shared? They said, we need to do this too to help our friends and community so they can work through this too. And so if there is any other stories, and if you're not comfortable, you could write those stories out and share them with Colin and Danielle later. Send them a text. Take a little video if you want, because I know they will cherish those stories forever and ever and will never grow tired of wanting to see those. Okay, so we're going to have our farewell to Noah. And I've taken it from Winnie the Pooh. I thought it was quite appropriate. If ever there is tomorrow when we're not together, there is something you must always remember. You are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, and smarter than you think. But the most important thing, even if we're apart, I'll always be with you. Noah Hill Lucan, rest in peace till we see each other on the other side. Take care, little boy.
Sunshine, my only sunshine. So